Hi guys.
Hi.
Dave, this question is for you. I'm Jonathan from Republic Forces Radio Network. With George Lucas's announced impending retirement, is your role going to step up with things outside the Clone Wars?
No, I don't think so. I mean, I think that his retirement to us just means that he has more free time to come and watch the show. So I don't believe, I always tell him I don't believe him. When he stops showing up, then I'll believe him. But he has my cell phone number and he calls me with notes. He did that this week while I'm in Orlando. So, and you know, I don't, you know, he's taught me well to make all these decisions without him here. He told me years ago when he started that one of the reasons that I'm here is to make sure when he's not around that things go the way he wants. And so, you know, I think it's a compliment to myself, my crew, to, you know, the different divisions of Lucasfilm that he feels confident in all of us enough to say that he'd retire. And then he's done a great thing for us as a company by bringing someone like Kathleen Kennedy on to, you know, take over the reins. And I'm really excited about what she's going to bring to the table. My focus remains Clone Wars. And, you know, perhaps other projects that we may do in the future of Lucasfilm Animation, because I think as a division we've grown, we've shown and demonstrated an ability to put out a really, I think, high quality of animation. I think Detours continues that tradition if you've seen any of the animation they've done. And, you know, I just look forward to all the things we're going to be doing in our many divisions. But Clone Wars is always my focus.
Okay, thank you.
Who's next?
This question's for Dave. I was Brett Watson, the geek. How many seasons have you written out? We're at five. You mentioned six last night. We're definitely going to see a 7, 8, 9, 10.
You know, I've always said, you know, we'll keep making these episodes as long as people are watching them because of the demands of our production schedule to deliver this high quality product. We work very far in advance. We have all of season five finished, and of course, we have been actually working on the scripts and designs that would be delivered for a season six. Some, you know, I hate to say it, some fantastic stuff, some amazing stuff. Will you see it? You know, that's up to the people above me in the business world. So, you know, I hope so. And but we go season to season. Cartoon Network's been a great partner for us. I've always been excited by their support and everything they've done for the show. So, you know, right now I'll just focus on season five, and you know, if you've seen the trailer, you know the exciting things you're gonna see this year. So.
Well, why the change on the schedule? Why the change from 9 o'clock to Fridays?
They've actually moved their entire action block to Saturday mornings, and so we go with that. And you know, I don't know. I mean, we might find an even bigger audience on Saturday mornings. I mean, I can remember as a kid being ecstatic about Saturday mornings. I used to get up to see Dungeons and Dragons. That was like my favorite Saturday morning. So there was no way I was missing that show. So if that's what we become, you know, I think that's great for the people that, you know, go out Friday night and can't get up early Saturday morning, so to speak. I'm sure they're going to be DVRing the show. So it'll be interesting to see how the audience responds to it.
You made mention last night during the thing about it's better on the big screen. Are we going to have a second Clone Wars movie?
You know, I really can't say. You know, I think
that didn't mean anything.
Don't look at me.
These two. You know, my whole thing is I think that it's great when the fans demand stuff. I think when you guys bring it up, I think that always helps motivate things. And
why are they blushing? I'm just curious.
These two over here, you're doing it again. Yeah. 7 years, Padawan. 7 years. But, you know, we focus, Joel and I, on making the quality of the show as cinematic as possible. We shoot at 2-3-5. It's ready to be projected, as you saw last night, anytime. And the stories are written as such as well. So I'm happy with it where it is. You know, on TV, I'm very proud that we bring that level of quality to TV each week. But, you know, we are a film company, Lucasfilm, and we always plan on delivering that type of quality to you guys wherever it is.
Thank you.
Jonathan?
Hi, guys. We recently had a fan poll with the Insider for the best episodes of the season, the last season of Clone Wars. And it's not going to be published till October the 23rd, but I'm going to tell you that the best episode, according to the fans, was Revenge. Why do you think that one resonated?
I've answered everything up
here. Your guess is as good as mine. I mean, in terms of Darth Maul, you know, the guy's got the Boba Fett factor going for him, you know? He looks cool, and there was an attitude that was established in that movie. So I think our job was just to, I mean, you can't do the same thing. You can't bring the character back and have it be exactly what it was, you know? So we actually had to sit around and talk about, well, if there could be two Sith, you don't just pick a guy who's good at sword fighting. He's got to be good at pretty much everything. If you're going to pick another, you know, an apprentice and actually spend years training him, he's got to be really smart. And he's got to be someone who could eventually take over the mantle of master. And so, but aside from all of, it was always our aspiration to go there, which you will see in this season. You'll start discovering new elements of his character. But the big thing for Revenge and for Brothers was to just describe the cost of what had happened to him, not just physically, but mentally. And then also just to show you the unadulterated dark side of the Force, you know, like this is what it is. It isn't just cool leather suits and red lightsabers, it's madness and it's despair and it's pain. You know, that's sort of where we went with it. So he'll get funnier as he goes on.
Funnier.
he becomes hilarious. And then they just poured him over the detours.
Careful.
Careful. All right.
Following up on that, Sam, what's it like for you as an actor, and is there any additional pressure in the fact that you closed out last season and you kick off this season?
Yeah.
So here's this huge cast and all these people that have been working together on this show for a while, and then it's the Sam Witwer show for the end of season 4 and the start of season 5.
Well, it's not, it's the Star Wars show. It's not, you know,